Bam!
Mr. Tarrou, in this problem, we are going to combine our knowledge of geometrically representing vectors, finding the resultant or the sum of vectors using a triangular method, and doing some basic algebraic operations with vectors, simply just adding and subtracting them. And we're going to do this. We're going to be given some vertices of this cuboid. It may also be a parallelepiped in your problem. And from those vertices, we're going to find vector AC, AD, and CG. And then we have part two of this question that says, hence, determine the position vectors of BE, F, and vertice H. Well, hence means that for part B, you need to, you have to, if you want full credit, use the information that you were either given or that you found more than likely in a previous part of the question. So to answer part B, we're going to have to use the vectors that we found in part A. Okay, now, you don't have to draw a three-dimensional sort of graph or system, if you will, and place this exactly where it belongs in space. Though if it helps you, you can go ahead and do that. You can just use this information given and build off of that to answer part B, and let me show you how. We're first going to find vector AC. Okay, well, that means that we're going to be doing the terminal, each of the components of the terminal point minus each of the corresponding components of the initial point. So vector AC is going to be the result of doing the position vector OC minus the position vector of for the coordinate of A, or you may just be with your textbook just straight up subtracting each of these components. And even though I'm writing this notation, that's exactly what I'm going to do. AC is going to be equal to 2 minus 6, subtracting the x components, now the y components, negative 3 minus negative 2, and the z components, 5 minus 3. So vector AC is going to be equal to negative 4. Negative 3 plus 2, of course, is negative 1 and 2. Vector AD, well, that is going to be the result, again, terminal minus initial, each of those corresponding components. So we have 7 minus 6, 0 minus negative 2, and 6 minus 3, given us that AD, vector AD, is equal to 1, 2, and 3. And then vector CG, I meant to color code these. Yeah, and vector CG, okay, so not the same initial point of A now, so pay attention to what you're doing. Terminal minus initial, or the position vector for vector, position vector for coordinate G, and the minus the position vector for coordinate C, so vector OG minus vector OC, or just subtracting the components, 3 minus G, C, okay, so 3 minus 2, trying not to make a careless mistake, negative 5, minus negative 3, 6 minus 5, so vector C, G is equal to 1, negative 5 plus 3 is negative 2, and 1. And let me just make sure I haven't made some kind of silly mistake. No. Okay. So now when I get to part B, and it says, hence, use these three vectors to find the position vectors. So we're going to find vector OB, vector OE, OF, and finally vector OH. Using these three vectors, let's make sure that you know how to use that triangular method process to add multiple vectors and move along space, throughout space. And so to do this, to make sure I understand really what I'm doing, I'm going to go ahead and color code these vectors in our cuboids. We have vector AC. So we have vector A, which is negative 4, negative 1, 2, which is going to take us in space from the front left corner of this cuboid down to the back right lower corner. And I'm just going to count on the color coding here to keep track of what I'm doing. Vector AD. So if I want to go from vertice A to vertice D, I'm going to move to the forward one on the x-axis, to the right two on the y-axis, and up three. So this is vector AD. I'm hoping that the green differentiates itself enough from the blue up here. And then finally we have vector CG going from vector coordinate or vertice C to vertice G. Okay. Now, how can I use these three vectors, the green, the white, and the orange, AD, AC, and vector CG, to create the, or write the position vector for coordinate B? So I have to start at the origin. Now, two of my given vertices start from vertex A, and I want to move through this cuboid, or maybe a parallelepiped on your particular problem, depends on what, you know, your book writes out. So I'm going to just say, hey, let's get from the origin to A, and then use these three vectors to move around this cuboid to get to whatever vertice we need. So we're going to do first vector OA. Okay, so we move wherever this is in space, there's an origin, and we move to vertice A. And we want to get to vertice B. Okay, so if I'm here in my cuboid and I want to move to this vertex or vertice of B, only using these three vectors, well, there's no given, none of these three vectors simply move from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. And yeah, it'd be nice to say, well, it's vector OA plus vector AB, but then I'm not using one of these three vectors. That wouldn't get you full credit. That's why I'm not just saying it's OA plus AB. So we're gonna go from somewhere at the origin to A. How about we get back to C? Because that vector AC is gonna take us from the left-hand side to the right-hand side of this cuboid. So we have plus AC. So we're somewhere in the origin, move to A, back to C. We need to go back towards B. Well, we have a vector that goes from front to back, so let's just subtract that. And so that would take us, that would be the opposite vector. Instead of going from front to back, it would move us from back to front. Now, because it says, hence, use these vectors exactly, you know, you could say minus AD, but I like this. I'm kind of wanting to write these out so that these letters attach. You go from O to A, the origin to A, from A to C, and then I want some notation that takes me from vertex C to vertex B. So since this is a cuboid, and thus it's kind of telling us that these what appear to be parallel sides actually are going to be parallel, we're going to say that this is, that CB is equal to, or that let's, understanding that AD is equal to CB, we can say that this is OA, vector OA, plus vector AC minus CD. So from the origin to A, from A to C, and now we're moving back in the opposite direction, we're subtracting or using the opposite vector of AD, which is CB. And that is going to be equal to, I'm definitely going to run out of room as I do this example, position vector for A, 6, negative 2, 3, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis movement. Vector AC, well, we just found that. Vector AC is negative 4, negative 1, 2. And then finally subtract vector CD, which is the same as vector AD. Well, AD is 1, 2, 3, so we're going to subtract vector CD, which is equivalent to AD. and all this comes out to OB is equal to 6 plus negative 4 is 2, minus 1 is 1, negative 2 plus negative 1 is negative 3, now minus 2 is negative 5, and 3 plus 2 is 5, minus 3 is equal to 2. And one more time, just for clarity, let's bring this notation over here. This is the position vector for vector OB, and I do want to check my work just to make sure I'm not doing something silly. Okay, OE. Well, OE, let's see here, just pick a different color to differentiate it. Again, let's get from the origin to A, get a starting point there. Okay, this is going to take us from the origin to vertex A. Now we need to get to E. Oh, we just have to go up. And we have a vector that moves us up. Vector CG is a vertical component of this cuboid. So we're going to do OA plus CG, but as this is a cuboid, it'd be the same as if it was a parallelepiped. CG is equivalent to AE. And that means that OE is equal to, actually, you know what? It's not a great idea, really, to write an equal sign next to every line of work. Let's do scratch work and then finalize your answer when you're done. OA plus AE, which is equivalent to CG. And we found that already, hence using that previous information. And therefore, OE, 6 plus 1 is 7, negative 2 plus negative 2 is negative 4, and 3 plus 1 is equal to positive 4. And that is how you do that last one. So we're finding four coordinates, four vertices. It's going to be similar to this, so I'm going to step out. Maybe you should pause the video, try and find these other two, the position vectors for these other two vertices yourself, and I'm going to pause the video. I'll just display the work for each of these two answers quietly, giving you a chance to try it out, and that is the end of our lesson. So we have position vector for OF is OA, AC plus vector CG minus GF. So that meant, again, we went from the origin to A. So now we're at A, then AC. From C, we went CG, because we had to go from the bottom of the cuboid to the top plane of that cuboid. And then minus GF, minus GF, because we're trying to go back to F. Now, I went straight away and wrote minus vector GF, but of course we have vector AD is equivalent to vector FG. AD is going from front to back, so we did the subtraction to go in the opposite direction and move from the back of the cuboid to the front. And then just filled in all the position vectors and the vectors that we found in part A. Again, that's part of this problem. OH from origin to A, from A to D, and then from finally D to H. Now, Mr. True, bam, go do your homework.